Hello people, welcome to this video. Let's see how to use the awesome effects and transitions inside Vegas Pro 14. Leave us comments below to help us improve our future guides for Vegas Pro. Let's start with the effects. Effects are added to the clips inside the timeline in order to make them cooler and effective. There are two main kinds of effects: the video effects that are applied on video, image, and text clips, and the audio effects applied to audio clips only. All video effects available inside Vegas Pro are collected inside the Video FX panel. If you have it closed, you can open it by going to View, Window, and then to Video FX. This panel is quite useful. For each effect selected on the left, several ready-made templates are shown that you can check by hovering on them with your pointer. Then, you can simply drag and drop the selected template to the interested clip on the timeline to add such effect. After that, a new window called Video Event FX appears, which is used to fully edit and customize the final effect applied to your clip. Depending on the effect added, the interface changes through which you can adjust all the effect settings while checking the video preview. Also, in case you want to save a fixed setting or preset for the chosen effect, you can rename it and then go to Save Preset to save it. This will be listed under Preset with its name. Once you close the Video Event FX window, all settings will be saved. You can open this interface again by clicking on the Event FX icon on the clip or right-clicking on the clip and going to Video Event FX. To understand how to manage the effects, let's see in detail how this Video Event FX window works. At the very top, this window shows the effect chain that is applied on the chosen clip. This is a list that shows from the left to the right all the effects applied in order. You can change it by clicking and dragging an effect through the chain. Depending on the order, the overall clip appearance changes. By default, any clip has one effect called Pan Crop that is used to regulate the basic clip appearance on your preview, such as its position, scaling, and inclination, by editing the rectangle shown. To learn more about the Event Pan Crop effect, check out our related video inside this guide. Then, when you add other effects, these will be listed inside this chain one after another. The Video Event FX interface will show the selected effect inside the chain highlighted in blue, but you can check and edit other effects by selecting them. Also, you can enable or disable an effect by checking and unchecking it, or remove it from the clip by selecting it and going to Remove Selected Plugin. To add new effects to the chain, you can use Plugin Chain on the right, choosing inside the whole list, and going to Add, and then to OK to apply. Besides video effects, you also have audio effects for your audio clips. However, these are not listed inside the Video FX panel. To add them, you have to open the Video Event FX window from the clips and search for your audio effects in the list. Some of these effects are digital and show an orange icon on the left. Some others are fully analog, showing a blue icon. As seen for the video effects, also, the audio effects are organized inside a chain and can be managed and modified in the same way. Even more, video and audio effects can also be applied on whole video and audio tracks, respectively. If you add effects by using the Track FX icon on the tracks, you will add effects that will be applied on the whole track content. Differently from the singular clips inside video tracks, you do not have any default event pan crop effect applied. To move, scale, and rotate the whole track content, you have to use the track motion feature. Check out our related video to see how to use the track motion effect. Let's now see the transitions. These are special effects used to make a clip appear and disappear in a cool way. Let's take, for example, a visible clip, which can be any video, picture, or text. If you approach its top corners and click and drag, you will create a fade transition, which is a simple transition that changes the clip opacity in time, according to the envelope line shown on the clip. You can change the duration of the transition by dragging its extreme edge on the left or right. If you shorten its duration to 0, you will remove the transition. Also, you can change the fade effect by right-clicking on the envelope line and going to Fade Type. You can also apply transitions between clips that do overlap in time. If you have the automatic crossfades feature enabled and overlap two clips on the same track in time, a crossfade is created. This is a smooth fade transition where you go from the first clip to the second one. This will last as much as the clips overlap in time and is removed if the two clips are put far enough. You can apply special transitions by using the Transitions panel. If closed, you can find it under View, Window, Transitions. As seen for the effects, this panel lists all the transitions available inside Vegas, including several ready-made templates for your video, image, and text clips. To apply one, just drag and drop it on the extreme edges of a single clip or directly on a crossfade if you have clips overlapping. In this case, you won't see any opacity line since these kind of transitions are special effects instead of fades. Once added, the Video Event FX window opens, which is used to customize your transition as you like. With respect to what is seen for the effects, you can't build any transition chain in this case. You can just apply one kind of transition per fade-in, fade-out, and crossfade per time. In fact, if you drag and drop a second transition on an existing one, the old one will be replaced. To adjust the transition settings again, you can open the Video Event FX window by going to Transition Properties. If you want to remove any special transition and come back to the simple fade one, just right-click on the transition, go to Transition, and then to Change to Crossfade. Inside Vegas, you can apply audio transitions as well, although these are quite simple and work by applying a volume fade in time. You can edit it by right-clicking on it and going to Fade Type to change the volume envelope shape. You can also personalize both effects and transitions in time by using the keyframes and the local timeline inside Video Event FX. For example, let's pick an effect called Gradient Map. On the Video Event FX window, you have the Animate button below. If you click on it, a local timeline appears that lasts as much as the clip is and welcomes the keyframes used to apply variable settings in time. Each keyframe saves a fixed setting of your effect or transition in the instant of time they are placed on the local timeline, so that when two keyframes with different settings saved are placed in two different instants of time, a transition is made, where the effect or transition appearance changes by passing from the first keyframe to the second one. By default, you have a single keyframe on the local timeline representing the effect setting you start from. As long as you don't add other keyframes, the effect remains static in time. You can add other keyframes by placing the local playhead in another instant of time and then changing the settings above. In this way, a new keyframe will be automatically created. To check the effect, play back the interested clip from the main timeline. You can also move a keyframe in time by clicking and dragging it on the local timeline. To delete the keyframe or change the transition fade created with the next keyframes, just right-click on it. Pay attention on the local timeline. This changes depending on the kind of effect you are changing in time. In the oldest effects, like the gradient map, you have to click on the Animate button and you have a local timeline showing the effect on one row only. This means that all the keyframes added to this track do save all the settings you see above. But in the most recent effects, like the Vegas ones, or the effects coming from third-party plugins, you have these effects that are composed by multiple rows, one for each single effect property you see on the Video Event FX interface, that have their watch icon enabled besides them. So in this case, each keyframe inside a particular property track does not save all the effect settings, just the settings related to that property. Do not confuse the tracks dedicated to properties and the ones dedicated to the different effects applied to the clip. The properties are always contained inside the main effect track on the local timeline. To fully remove all the keyframes applied to a single property, just disable its watch icon. This is all you need to know to start with effects and transitions on Vegas Pro 14. Check out our full guide for more amazing video tutorials.